When it comes to club soccer in the United States, a new year means a clean slate. This afternoon, two teams on different levels of the American soccer pyramid begin to write the story of their 2023 campaign.
Not the first time that these two teams have met. Familiar foes, first ever soccer match played in Finley by Chattanooga FC a handful of years ago. Atlanta on an early break. We'll tell the story as we go.
Ball at his feet, and a big moment for Miles Robinson, John, is just getting over that mental hurdle. Today is a big part of that.
That end with Brad Guzan, you had the two Achilles injuries for two of your stars for Atlanta United, working your way through. Machoke Chole now in possession for Atlanta United. Obviously, a lot of the Five Stripes fans, the 17s here today at Finley, looking forward to seeing what they're going to get out of the polar bear in net. And Miles Robinson, who was on the path to national team minutes and consistency and being a part of that back line for the Stars and Stripes, now getting his first minutes here in 2023, a welcome sight for all the 17s.
Chole hugs the touchline and tries to wiggle out of it before he's chopped down. That is Jungwoo So, a trialist, one of many taking the field today for Chattanooga. In fact, 11 of the 24 on Chattanooga's roster day trialists. That head coach Rod Underwood, the 2022 NISA Coach of the Year, wants to get a good look at. Really today for Chattanooga, John, it's about the big picture, about finding depth pieces. And despite facing an MLS side, they're not hanging back. They're not going to sit back and counter, because that's just not what they want to do when they get into NISA play.
And for Atlanta United, literally it is getting to know you because of Miles Robinson being back in the lineup. He's paired with Juanjo Purata, who garnered the nickname Air Force One because of his presence in the air on set pieces. Picked up in midseason, Andrew Gutman trying to send it inside the six. Last touch by Atlanta United, going to be a throw for Chattanooga FC. But it's in this first action, it's about those little societies that we like to talk about, trying to figure out, okay, so if the guy to my left does this, what do I do in return? It's finding out those relationships and working on that here in this first match of the season for both of these sides.
Most of the action in Chattanooga's half. An early start to the preseason, at least for Chattanooga, about 3 weeks than they're used to. We'll head to Memphis in mid-February to continue that preseason campaign, as Atlanta United will get ready to take a trip to Mexico, gearing up for the MLS opener February 25th at home against San Jose. Here's Robinson. Santi Sosa. It's broken up in Chattanooga, trying to create numbers, pushing forward down that right flank. Alex McGrath and Damian Rodriguez combining on the right side. Going to hear that a lot if you're a Chattanooga fan in 2023. It's at the back line with Stripling to his partner, Corin. Ethan Corin splitting midfielders, winning the first free kick of the match. Chattanooga trying to create something in Atlanta United's half.
Foul call on Santi Sosa there, just past the halfway line. Jackson Conway making sure that there isn't any kind of a quick start forward for Chattanooga FC.
Third meeting between these two, back where it all began in 2017, the first preseason match for Atlanta United ahead of their inaugural MLS campaign happened right here, a 4-0 win over Chattanooga, then an NPSL side, and then second meeting in 2022, a U.S. Open Cup fixture, a game Atlanta United won 6-0 in the third round. Here's Purata. Robinson surveys the scene, sends it down the line. Luis Araujo hoping for a big 2023. Looping to the near side for Gutman, who will let that trickle out for an Atlanta throw-in.
Atlanta United looking a little different numbers-wise. You'll see some of the players wearing numbers in 23 that were different back in 22. Luis Araujo wearing number 10. Mateus Osechu is wearing number 20 this year. We'll go into more as we go, but those are the two right now for the 11 that Atlanta United have right there. Andrew Gutman can't control. Thumbs up on the idea. It's going to be a goal kick for Chattanooga FC.
A heavy touch for the first round pick by Atlanta in the 2020 re-entry draft, Andrew Gutman. Back with Antoine. Chattanooga second place finishers in NISA in 2022. Five CFC players named to the NISA Best 11 first or second team. One of those on the ball, and Richard Dixon, the captain. And here comes CFC at home. A crowd of 6,000 on hand to watch the preseason kickoff for 2023.
Well done there by Brooks Lennon to get in the way of that pass. Chattanooga FC resets.
Guzan keeps it in. Could be an opportunity for CFC, and it's a one-touch finish. Marcus Nagelstad. And it's a shock lead for Chattanooga FC, the NISA Golden Boot winner in 2022. Puts David in front of Goliath in the eighth minute.
Mishandled by Brad Guzan as he tried to keep it from going over the end line. Pass found Nagelstad for the easy drop in, 1-0 to the home side here at Finley Stadium.
20 goals in NISA play last season for Marcus Nagelstad, the 31-year-old Norwegian. NISA Golden Ball, Golden Boot winner. And he's started Chattanooga off on the right foot in this preseason friendly. Ethan Corrin. And here's Alex McGrath. Going to be a huge part of what Chattanooga wants to do under Rod Underwood. And, John, about as promising a start that you could possibly ask for if you're Chattanooga coach Rod Underwood.
No doubt about it. You're up against a fan base that has traveled the 2+ hours. You're in your barn. And as you mentioned, coming in 3 weeks ahead of your normal planning schedule, and you capitalize on an error from the keeper in Brad Guzan, deposit it in the net, 1-0. And that just adds to the confidence of a Chattanooga side early on that wants to do what they're going to do. They're not going to deviate from their game plan. And, you know, when we caught up with Coach Underwood this week, it was, we're going to do what we do. You really can't focus on the other guy. We're going to do our thing. And now you get to do it with a one-goal advantage out of the blocks. 3 weeks early, one goal ahead of the game.
Well, he understood the logic from Rod Underwood, right, when he talks about, that's what we're going to do in NISA play. We want to play attractive football. We want to create the tempo. Why deviate from that in a preseason friendly when you can see what you have against the very top of the American soccer pyramid.
And here's one of the tenets that we have come to see from a Gonzalo Pineda side with Atlanta United, trying to regain possession as quickly as possible once you lose it. If you're Atlanta United, you want to have possession. You want to have it a majority of the time. You want to build from the back. If you lose possession, you try to regain it as quickly as possible. That pressure is going to be evident here today. And then once again, you look at the relationships that are there, trying to figure out, okay, if the guy to my left does this, then what do I do in return? So it's all about trying to find out what your partners are doing, and a player's down for Atlanta United.
And an opportunity on a defensive error by Chattanooga. Atlanta unable to capitalize.
Now a player down for CFC, Machope Chole on the left.
They'll continue on here as Richard Dixon leaves for Rodriguez, and Chole is clipped. Play kept alive. Still a CFC player down, and penalty given to Atlanta United.
Andrew Gutman taken down inside the box. Protestations, obviously, from Chattanooga FC. But Nima Sagafi, named very, very familiar to those who watch Major League Soccer. Sagafi wasted no time pointing to the spot. Atlanta United with a chance at an equalizer here late in the 11th minute.
Mwape was the man down for Chattanooga, now walking it off. And Luis Araujo with a chance to equalize inside the first 11 minutes here at Finley Stadium. Araujo, the 26-year-old, trying to regain some of that confidence lost throughout the course of the 2022 season against Jean Antoine. Slotted into the right corner, and we're level in Scenic City.
The hesitation by Araujo. Jean Antoine commits to his right with the lean, powered through by the left foot of Luis Araujo, and we're equal at one.
Feels like a big year for Luis Araujo. When you hear from Gonzalo Pineda talking about him, says he lost some of that confidence and just wants to get him back to where he should be in that sense after such a hot start to 2022 and just kind of tailing off there on what was certainly a tumultuous season for Atlanta United.
Not making the playoffs for Atlanta United, and Luis Araujo on that right-hand side has a lethal left foot, and he wanted the responsibility of trying to will the team forward at home and trying to garner 3 points. And when you have a guy like Luis Araujo who wants that kind of responsibility, and Gonzalo Pineda trying to get him back to the confident player that he was, moments like this, letting him be the one to take the penalty out of the blocks, that kind of trust from your head coach can only amplify that going forward.
Even for a guy that's played in the top flight in Brazil, in France, maybe to the neutral viewer may seem like a small feat, a penalty kick against the Nisa opponent on the road, but big moment for Luis Araujo.
And there's the pressure that we talk about from Atlanta United, trying to get possession away from Chattanooga FC, forcing the ball out from the back. Now Atlanta United with a throw. You're seeing pressure from up top. You're seeing Jackson Conway working forward, Franco Ibarra working forward. A lot of that pressure coming from the center and from the right-hand side of the attack for Atlanta United, forcing Chattanooga FC into some quick decisions and try to force some mistakes in thought.
Well, if you wanted goals this afternoon, off to a good start in that regard.
Yes, indeed. 2 and 12 minutes will do that. You like that average in your first game out of the blocks if you're a fan, not necessarily if you're a coach,
sure.
If you're Rod Underwood or Gonzalo Pineda. But you've got 2 goals on the board in the first 12 minutes here for the 6,000-plus at Finley.
So, one of the open trialists on hand for Chattanooga today. Playing right back, wearing number 2 in blue. Turned over. Sosa will start over as try to generate something from the feet of Miles Robinson here. Araujo. Second full season under Gonzalo Pineda. Atlanta kind of turning the page. New leadership in the front office. Garth Lagerwey comes in for the departing Darren Eels, off to Newcastle United as the CEO reunited with another former Atlanta United star in Newcastle, Miguel Almiron.
I've heard of him. But, yeah, absences or turnover for Atlanta United. Alan Franco has moved on. Emerson Heineman has moved on. Joseph Martinez has moved on to Inter Miami. Marcelino Moreno has gone back to South America to play. So there's some opportunities here for some players, and there's also opportunity for players to be brought into this next stage of Atlanta United as well to fit into what Gonzalo Pineda and his staff are looking to do.
And you mentioned that name, Joseph Martinez. 100 career goals to his name in an Atlanta uniform as Chattanooga tries to create something here with Damian Rodriguez on the back of Gutman and able to win a Chattanooga corner.
Yeah, Andrew Gutman had two touches, was trying to look over his shoulder and try to figure out where Damian Rodriguez was. Ball ends up going over the end line, so it'll be a corner here. The right-hand side for Chattanooga FC.
Mwape to take. We'll play it short. McGrath slices it into the box where it's right back at the left foot of Mwape. Going to try to keep it in play here. Can't do it. And some frustration for Chattanooga, squandering an opportunity there with the first corner kick of the game. 16 minutes in, level at one.
But once again, you're in your first action. It's trying to figure out, okay, I want this much weight on the ball. I want it here. I want it here. I want it here. You're going to be seeing that, obviously, in the preseason. And, you know, 17 minutes in, you're just trying to get these relationships figured out in the first opportunity to do so here today.
Well, that's certainly the name of the game today on both sides, isn't it? You mentioned the getting to know you factor for Atlanta United as that's deflected out for a Chattanooga throw. So put it into play for Rodriguez, the youngster that Chattanooga fans have been excited about for a couple of years. Will stay with CFC. But always a challenge in these preseason friendlies, putting new faces together and trying to create that chemistry that's going to be so important come February 25th for Atlanta United with that MLS opener.
Yeah, we mentioned the relationship, at least here in the first 45 for Atlanta United, with Juanjo Purata and Miles Robinson. Purata being that force that he developed into for Gonzalo Pineda and Atlanta United. And now you end up playing next to a talent like a Miles Robinson. You get the polar bear back in net with Brad Gazan. All these faces that are familiar to the 17s. You had 20 injuries among 17 different players last year for Atlanta United. And you're looking at this lineup that's out here now here in the first 45. It's a lot of familiar names, a lot of first-class names.
Well, that center-back pairing, a great example of that, right? Purata, a guy who comes in mid-season after the Robinson injury, has never actually gotten an opportunity to take the field with Miles Robinson. As Purata on the ball. Sosa trying to turn out of pressure. Does so with Miles Robinson. And here's Araujo. Motors into the center of the pitch, and it's turned over. Pressure from Joel and thumped clear by Antoine. We'll start back at the foot of Purata, and Miles Robinson heads to Sosa as Chattanooga upping the pressure in Atlanta's half. Alex McGrath upping the pressure, I should say. Purata switching sides.
Not Perez. Enough on it. Not enough on that. Looking for Brooks Lennon over on the right-hand side. Lennon calling for it one more time.
Here comes Atlanta. Chol curls to the near post. It bounces safely into the arms of Jean Antoine.
Good look there from Machope Chol. He saw the opportunity. Didn't have a large window to try to take the shot, but did have the confidence to try to take it, challenging Antoine early on here, early in the 20th minute with the score tied at one.
Six MLS appearances for Chol in 2022. Homegrown player, 24-year-old from Sudan. Getting the start on the left wing for Gonzalo Pineda. Here's Atlanta tearing down the right side, splitting inside, and it's Chol with the easiest finish he could possibly find. Jean-Antoine coming out creates a deflected gift for the 24-year-old, and Atlanta United has its first lead in the 20th minute.
And we mentioned those relationships and getting to know you when you have two players from the back for Chattanooga FC collapsing, Antoine coming out. You wonder who is going to sit there and say, okay, this is mine. And all three get lost in that conversation. And Machoke Chol, the benefactor of all of that miscommunication and trying to collapse onto that ball there inside the 18, Chope gets a goal, 2-1, and we're back at it again.
Right place, right time for Chol. Antoine, certainly one of those new faces for Chattanooga. As we said, Golden Glove winner for the NISA winning Cal United Strikers in 2022. His first appearance in a Chattanooga uniform. Atlanta back in Scenic City for the first time in 6 years with a 2-1 lead. Guzan got that first mistake out of the way, right? It feels like such a big step for goalkeepers coming back from a long layoff. That first mistake that led to the 8th-minute goal by Marcus Nagelstadt.
Yeah, and it's just getting into the rhythm of game state. And you're looking at this, you know, once again, remember Brad's been practicing with the club, the recovery from the Achilles injury. Nice idea there from Gutman working out of the back. Now Chol in control.
Nifty move by Chol to get past So. Squares it across the middle, and it's cut off well by CFC. The touch by Rodriguez, but unable to spin out of it with control. It's an Atlanta throw.
Remember, if you're looking at Fred Atlanta United for the first time, one of the tenets of Gonzalo Pineda, pressure to regain possession or gain possession as quickly as you can. We've been seeing that against Chattanooga here out of the blocks. Brooks Lennon.
Service from Lennon is punched away by Antoine. Gutman going for the one-time volley, and Rodriguez puts his body on the line. Sosa. One goal in 21 appearances for Atlanta in 2022 for Santi Sosa. Former River Plate midfielder.
Force as a defensive midfielder. A lot of folks will remember Santi Sosa reminding Blaise Matuidi of Inter Miami that Major League Soccer is a little different than you first might have pictured. The kind of physical presence that you get from Santi Sosa. Sosa not afraid to engage and come forward when the situation is there and presented to him as well.
Alex McGrath accelerates, dishes it down the left touchline, and just not enough time for Jimenez to get there. Alex Jimenez, former member of the NC State Wolfpack. Chol with space. Gave Atlanta a 2-1 lead in the 20th minute. This combination nearly has Gutman free in the area, but it's broken up. And Chattanooga will try to create something of a counter here.
Earlier this week, in preparation for this match against Chattanooga FC, Andrew Gutman admitted that he wasn't 100% last year. He was fighting a quad. From what we've seen from Andrew Gutman, if you're an Atlanta United fan, that quad looks at 100%, and that's what you're looking for from, I guess, literally, it's almost like a striker back position where
right.
You see him working on the runs on the inside, used to being that left back, but more than willing to make the cut, work the inside channels and go forward, and you're seeing the results of that. You saw it last season as he was managing that quad injury, but at the same time now at 100%, those inside channel runs from Andrew Gutman, really something to keep an eye on this season if you're an Atlanta United fan. Has set you to Chol on the left.
Chol against So. start over with Gutman. And now Sosa lifts it to Robinson. How's Robinson getting his feet back under him? Lennon with two CFC players in front of him. A nice chip to the center of the area, and Chole just couldn't get the touch he wanted on it. Antoine comes out. And you can see that process, right? Gene Antoine with a fist bump with Colin Stripling. First time those two have ever taken the field together. Stripling, former Stumptown Athletic defender under head coach Rod Underwood. Just establishing that connection between defender and goalkeeper in this first preseason matchup.
And something, if you're an offensive player, that you can take advantage of, as we saw with the third goal that we had on the board this afternoon.
McGrath. Perez. They call him JP. Jets into the Atlanta half. Richard Dixon. Slow rolls back to Perez. Errant pass from Corin. And Robinson combines with Conway, who is a little too strong on the one-time pass down the right side. Jackson Conway, a name that we haven't said much. A lot of eyes on him this preseason, John, is at the moment the only center forward on the first team roster.
Yep. A lot of time with Atlanta United, too, and a foul there on Atlanta United. Nima Sagafi perhaps calling over for a conversation. First conversation of the day. And it will be with Franco Ibarra. But, yeah, Jackson Conway, a lot of time with Atlanta United, too. We've seen his game continue to grow and evolve. And this is an opportunity for Jackson Conway to be a part of that discussion at center forward, be a part of the discussion at striker. He spent some time in the weight room in the offseason, looks a little bigger at first glance here in this first game that he did last season. We'll see how it affects him with his speed and mobility.
That's at the feet of Mwape, and it's at Nagelstad on the left foot. Nagelstad! A kick of the corner flag as he's equalized. A 28th minute brace for Marcus Nagelstad, and the fireworks are popping off at Finley Stadium. Rodriguez created the chance down the right side. Ball pinballed around in the area, and who else but Marcus Nagelstad to find the angle on Brad Guzan's right post.
Chaos inside the six. Nagelstad, the benefactor for CFC here. We've got a lot of different folks who are trying to either shoot it on net or clear it away. And by the end of the discussion with all of the cleats here on the turf at Finley, it ends up being a goal in the back of the net. We're tied at two.
Goal presented by Hojizio Grill right here in Chattanooga. Text GOAL, G-O-A-L, to 423-445-1002 for your chance to win a full Hojizio at Hojizio Grill. Match today presented by First Bank. We're level at two apiece. Chattahooligans on one side, the 17s on another. Couldn't ask for a much better atmosphere to kick things off in 2023. Here's Chole. Oh, cuts right past Richard Dixon. Chole continuing on. It's broken up by McGrath. And Dixon is pulled from behind, and that will be Josechu with the call.
And you saw Nima Sagafi put his arm around Mateus Josechu. Probably something along the lines of, under normal circumstances, that's a card.
Right.
This is the first match of the preseason. Just be cool. But yeah, under normal circumstances, that's a professional foul. That's a card. I think that Nima Sagafi's rule book is probably going to be a little looser under normal circumstances today than it would be.
Understandably so. We'll see exactly what it takes to get a card out of Sagafi's pocket this afternoon.
Careful now. I don't know if you want that. You want to make sure that everybody gets out of this particular match as healthy as humanly possible so these two sides can get back to work and Chattanooga FC gets into their Nisa season and Atlanta United works toward MLS. You don't want anything that presents a card situation.
Well, that'll certainly be a priority for Atlanta throughout the course of the preseason given the turbulent nature of 2022 with the amount of injuries.
Last year in Mexico, you had injuries to Machoke Chole and to George Campbell that stunted their growth in getting into the rhythm of the season. You don't want any kind of a repeat for that if you're an Atlanta United fan.
Burata. Gutman to Chole. Active first half for Andrew Gutman. Brooks Lennon stretching out the right side of that Chattanooga defense. That's driven across to nobody in particular.
Looking for Chole there. You saw Chole with the thumbs up inside the 18. Chole decided to cut to his left instead of standing pat on that left wing.
So with the throw-in.
So I think Chole was the intended target there.
Jung-woo Soh, one of three trialists in action for Chattanooga today that came to CFC via open tryout, getting a good look at him at right back. Someone Rod Underwood was very intentional about starting this afternoon to see what he has in the former Drury University defender. Sosa. Chole. Nice skill by Chole, and the combination from Gutman is broken up by Soh. And Nagelstad just couldn't send it down the line for Rodriguez, but does win the throw in, and he'll do it then. Robinson has the angle.
And that's what you're looking for if you're an Atlanta United fan, that closing speed. You think of Miles Robinson as like maybe a strong safety if you're a fan of American football, to have that kind of closing speed to close the receiver off so he can't get the long yardage play. Seeing that kind of work from Miles Robinson, positive out of the blocks if you're an Atlanta United fan.
Rodriguez surrounded by red shirts. A little too much time on the ball. It's broken up by Sosa. So who does that make the free safety when you're looking at an Atlanta United back line?
Well, probably if you're looking at that back four, if your corners are Lennon and Gutman, then your safeties in turn would be Miles and Juanjo Purata.
One time finish clears the bar.
And there's Luis again.
Araujo converted the spot kick that level things in the 12th minute for Atlanta. I would love for you to explain that to Juanjo Purata and just see what the reaction might be.
It's like you're strong safety, Miles is free safety, or vice versa, depending on what's going on. It's like you see one of the four, you see Nagelstad running a vert. It's your job to make sure that he doesn't get behind you.
The 25-year-old Mexican national, I'm sure, would have some questions.
That kind of dangerous pass you're looking to close down on with this pressure that we've been talking about. Franco Ibarra was almost there.
But when you talk about Purata along that Atlanta back line, it was an adjustment for him. Coming to Atlanta, his first stint in the United States, the language barrier, but he spoke really glowingly as this ball threaded through ahead to McGrath. And the left foot saved by Guzan. Purata defending.
And the first goose of the year from the 17s. And once again, if you're an Atlanta United fan, seeing Brad Guzan go to his right, make the save, collapse on the ball, have those kinds of moments that Atlanta United fans are used to. Another first for the season here in 2023.
Purata. Six goals last season for Atlanta United from the center back.
Yep, and
he really felt like he found a home.
And a hat trick in one game, and most of them on set on corners. And so you get that physical force coming in on set pieces, something that came to pass with Air Force One, as we say, in Atlanta. And it was great to see him become more comfortable and become a part of the process for Atlanta United. But yeah, Air Force One. So if we get a corner in the first 45, keep an eye out for 22 in red.
On the ball now, Air Force One to Gutman. 36 minute, 2-2. Nagelstad, the goal scorer for Chattanooga in both instances. Araujo and Chol for Atlanta United. Both teams have had a lead in this first half as Gutman on the left foot drives it across the 18. It's cut off.
Was looking for Chol there. Cut off effectively by Colin Stripling. And here's that pressure that we're talking about. Jackson Conway forcing a quick decision to sew. And you see Machoke Chol closing the distance there as well.
Talk about a big moment for a guy like Sow. Comes in an open tryout, gets the start against an MLS side. Has the throw in here.
Conway pressuring, Chol pressuring. Chol wins for Atlanta United. Back to Purata, and they'll start it all over again.
Araujo in the middle of the pitch. Dancing in front of Dixon.
And I know some folks might be asking about Thiago Almada. Almada took a knock in practice and so held out as a precaution today. I know a lot of folks that are either watching here in person or who are watching with us on 11 Sports might have been wondering about Almada or a lack of Almada's presence. Flag stays down.
Ball in the area, headed down. Gutman is there, shouts for a handball. It's cleared away, nothing given. A handball will be on Atlanta United. But right, Almada, of course, coming to town as the first ever active MLS player to win the World Cup, called up to the Argentinian national team just 5 days before that opening group stage match against Saudi Arabia. Of course, which Argentina went on to lose and then go on to win their fourth World Cup title. But precaution, the key word there, right?
Because it's the, you know, your first action here in the preseason. It's a long preseason. You have camp in Mexico. So you take a knock, just, you know, make sure that you're 100% going forward. It's okay.
What a reception Thiago Almada returned to at the Atlanta airport.
That was pretty cool. And I give full credit to the 17s for that, spreading the word and greeting Thiago Almada when he returned to Hartsfield-Jackson International Airport. Very, very cool moment. And how the 17s have come to embrace Thiago Almada. And understanding how important that moment was, yes, for Thiago Almada, yes, for Argentina, yes, for MLS, but even more so for Atlanta United.
Free kick here, Mwape down, clutching the right knee, and Damian Rodriguez ushering medical attention from the Chattanooga training staff. They'll come take a look at Mutaya Mwape, the 26-year-old from Zambia.
He's also shaking his hand, too. He's looking at his left hand.
Right.
This is the second time that Mwape has been down here in the first half. Remember, he was down just outside the 18 just before the Gutman penalty call as Atlanta United continued to play in their attack, because you don't have to stop play if a player is down and center ref doesn't blow his whistle. So Atlanta United continues offensively. They work it inside the 18. Gutman gets called for the penalty. Mwape was the player who was down then. Now the physio staff out taking a look at Moape in front of the Atlanta United bench.
Spent 2022 with Tormenta FC, USL League One champions, and Moape will walk off.
Joined them late in the year for their stretch run in the playoffs, had presence in three matches. Nagelstad wanting a foul called on Atlanta United, didn't get it.
Moape back on the field as McGrath controls. Lucas Panzica, John Nelson with you on 11 Sports. Gorgeous day for soccer in the scenic city. Temps in the mid-50s, hardly a cloud in the sky. And two goals aside as we're level here at Finley Stadium. Ball out for a Chattanooga throw-in. Expect to see a lot of changes in the second half, John.
Yeah.
So a few more minutes of first team action you would expect here. As we're inside the first 41 in East Tennessee.
Think of this almost like early spring training for baseball. If you're new to watching either Chattanooga FC or Atlanta United, think of it that way. With the first time out, you want to get the cobwebs out. You want to get the muscles warm. You want to get everyone reacquainted with, oh, we're in game state. But yeah, I would anticipate that you're going to see a lot of different faces in the next 45 for both Rod Underwood and Gonzalo Pineda.
No question, Rod Underwood got to be thrilled with what he's seen from his team, the home side today, Chattanooga. But what do you imagine is going through Gonzalo Pineda's mind, understanding a lot of moving parts, trying to discover some chemistry within his squad?
And it's one of those moments like we just saw right there with Jackson Conway, knowing that Mateus Osechu was off his left shoulder, and a goal for Atlanta United. Luis Araujo again.
And the same issues can plague Chattanooga. A mistake along the back line. Perez pickpocketed by Araujo. And in the 42nd minute, Atlanta United has its second lead with the second goal by the Brazilian.
Once again, we mentioned the ideas of, okay, first time out, relationships, getting used to how the player next to you or the player behind you is going to work with the ball. You end up with pressure. If I'm pressuring you, I know what I'm doing. It's up to you as the possessor of the ball to figure out, okay, what are my decisions here? And if I'm pressuring you hard, it forces you into a decision that you may not necessarily make ordinarily. You see what happens there. It turns into a goal for Atlanta United, and it's 3-2. We've gone 14 minutes without a goal, Lucas.
Far too long.
For some folks, not necessarily Coach Underwood or Coach Pineda.
Moape tracks it to the corner. Stripling, member of Seattle Sounders U23 back in 2017 when Garth Lagerwey was still calling the shots in Seattle. Foul going to go Chattanooga's way, called on Chull. And here comes
Chull. Can be a handful because of his body type. Very, very tall, very, very lanky. We've seen what he's been able to do offensively in the attacking third and inside the 18. And then trying to integrate how it is for Machope Cholan getting adjusted to how things are offensively and the health that you're looking for. Chance here for CFC.
Rodriguez, right side. Alex McGrath ties it up in the 44th minute. The goal fest of Finley Stadium. A moment of magic by the 20-year-old Damian Rodriguez that Chattanooga fans are so excited about, created along the right wing, and Alex McGrath cleans it up right in the middle of the six.
And you wanted to know about what these coaches will be working on going forward. The that is going to be a part of it. We mentioned relationships and who goes where and whose responsibility, who drops off, who comes on and chases forward. Rodriguez turns the corner. He sees the opportunity there. He has McGrath crashing just outside the six. Great vision from Rodriguez there. And once again, it's just trying to figure out, okay, someone turns a corner, whose responsibility is that? Trying to figure these kinds of things out here in match number one.
Well, for the Chattanooga side, as we approach the end of 45 minutes, offensively might be a picture-perfect preview of what CFC fans hope to see in 2023. Ball looped in and cleaned up by Gene Antoine.
And they were looking for Jackson Conway. You saw the idea there. Jackson Conway with his height, if it had been there, that would have been a header rocketed into the back of the net. You saw what the idea was there for Atlanta United.
1 minute of added time at Finley Stadium. Two goals for Marcus Nagelstad, one by Alex McGrath, assisted by Damian Rodriguez, three key cogs in this attacking machine of CFC, and maybe try and add one more here before that halftime whistle. Araujo and Chol, the goal scorers for Atlanta United. Araujo with two of the three.
Great work there by Hasechu to get the ball away from Damian Rodriguez to work another counterattack for Atlanta United, working right to left as you watch.
Final seconds of the first 45 at Finley Stadium. Foul in the center circle. Chattanooga free kick. Richard Dixon wearing the captain band for CFC, calming things down, perfectly content to head into the half with the game in its current state. And there it is. Two blows of the whistle from Nima Sagafi, and it's tied at three at the break between Chattanooga FC and Atlanta United. Well, John Nelson, I think these fans got their money's worth.
I think so.
Through the first 45.
Got to give the fans a lot of credit. The lines coming into Finley Stadium here to the side that is beneath the pictures as you watch. It is full here in the lower bowl. Lines were big coming in, and they've gotten their money's worth here. Three goals each side. Luis Araujo, a penalty in the 12th. Machoke Chol taking advantage of miscommunication at the back for CFC in the 20th. Araujo again out of miscommunication in the 42nd. Those are your three goals for Atlanta. You mentioned the three for CFC. Six in the first 45.
Halfway done at Finley Stadium. They expect to see some new faces in the second half. We'll dive into a second half preview and continue on with the preseason kickoff between Chattanooga and Atlanta United, tied at three on 11 Sports. Approaching second half action in Scenic City. Plenty of goals through the first 45. Knotted up at three at the half. Lucas Panzeca with you alongside John Nelson on 11 Sports. Appreciate you joining with us for the first preseason match of 2023. Chattanooga started the scoring in the 8th minute. Marcus Nagelstad capitalizing on a Brad Guzan mistake. And then two goals from Atlanta United. First from the penalty spot, Luis Araujo, followed by a capitalization on a mistake by Chol, and then a Chattanooga equalizer came in the 28th minute from Marcus Nagelstad, his second goal, and then goals in the 42nd minute again by Araujo for a brace, and then in the 45th for Chattanooga by Alex McGrath, have us where we are at 3-3, and John Nelson, several new faces coming into the game in this second
That's
half.
A word to phrase it, yes. Like I said, in the first half, think of this as a spring training game in baseball. You're going to have liberal substitutions, and that's what we have for at least Atlanta United. When we can kind of gauge what CFC looks like, it will be interesting. And so, for the record, I have 10 of the 11 substitutes figured out for Atlanta United. And so when I can figure out which one I'm missing, then we can figure it out. You will see. Okay, I've got them all now. All right, so here we go. In net for Atlanta United here in the second 45, you're going to see Quentin Westberg start. At the back, you're going to see Ronald Hernandez wearing number 2, Noah Cobb wearing 24. We can get into Noah Cobb as we go. Aiden McFadden, part of the discussion, he'll wear number 37. Alan Carlton, number 41. Nick Firmino, wearing 51. Luke Brennan, wearing 52. Tyler Young, the second-round draft pick in the last draft, number 36 overall, wearing 53. David Mejia, out on the left for Atlanta United 2 last year. He's out on the left-hand side. He's wearing 54. Kofi Tomasi, wearing number 60 at the back as a part of the back four. And it looks like Daniel Sabatu will be a part of the discussion, wearing number 61. So that's where we go here in the second half. Chattanooga FC in their CFC Blues working their way from right to left. Atlanta United in the dress reds from left to right.
Wholesale changes for Chattanooga FC as well. As you see, the majority of trialists that have been called into action by Rod Underwood this week coming into the game. Now left back Nick Burns, the former College of Charleston defender, on the ball and dishing to the right sideline. Taylor Krull, a center back that Rod Underwood wants to take a strong look at here in 2023 in the preseason, which will continue on, by the way. Chattanooga will head west to Memphis, taking on Memphis 901 February 11th in a closed preseason match, as the first action for new Chattanooga goalkeeper John Burke is a clearance for an Atlanta throw-in. So getting to know these guys as we move along here. Nick Firmino, the 21-year-old Brazilian for Atlanta United. It's pinged around along that left side. And here comes the first Atlanta-generated attack. 3-3 game in the first half with largely the first team for both squads. Turned over by Chattanooga. It's a right-footed try that slowly rolls to Burke.
Nick Firmino there with the first shot of the second half, wearing 51 for Atlanta United here in the second 45. Working at the back, it's Jake Krim wearing number 6. Hugo Martinez wearing 14 with his first touch.
And here's Nick Burns on the left foot, slices it inside where it's nothing but red shirts. This is Ronald Hernandez. Firmino. Luke Brennan, the 17-year-old, has it closed off by Chattanooga.
Jake Krim there closing off for CFC. And as we go here in the second 45, let's go ahead and open it up to social media. How about that? All right, so for those of you who are catching us here on 11 Sports and however you are accessing us today, large device or small, thanks for doing so. We're going to go ahead and open up our social media channels so they can find you on Twitter. How?
At Lucas Panzeca on Twitter.
LucasPan. Spell the Panzeca.
Well, I want to see you do it.
Well, I mean, I know how to because it's in my phone, Lucas. You got to do it for them.
Z-I-C-A. Let us know. I mean, you're talking about 17, 18-year-old Academy products for Atlanta United. Mm-hmm. Trying to make an impression, right? As much as the first half for Gonzalo Pineda was establishing that chemistry with the first team about Brad Guzan and Miles Robinson fixtures within this team, taking the field in a competitive atmosphere for the first time since a devastating injury, the second half will be just as much about first impressions for both Gonzalo Pineda with so many homegrown products wearing red, and for Chattanooga and Rod Underwood, trialists, 11 of which were assigned to the roster for today's match.
You can grab me on social media at OSG Nelson. And speaking of a grab, a bit of a horse collar tackle there as Ronald Hernandez hits the turf. So at Lucas Panzica, at OSG Nelson, let us know what you think about what's going on. Any questions that you have about CFC and about Atlanta United as we go here in the second 45. You know, as we mentioned with Atlanta United, you see Quentin Westberg getting his first touches. Westberg, last season at Toronto FC. Toronto FC signing Sean Johnson. They had vacancies, no Alex Bono, no Quentin Westberg, so they signed Sean Johnson, Brookwood High School product out of the Atlanta area. And so Westberg, because of all of the games that you're going to be playing if you're an MLS side this year, and this is also a part of the discussion that we have, you've got Leagues Cup, you've got Open Cup, you've got MLS, you have all of these different competitions, and so you're going to need deep rosters from an MLS side. And so bringing in a Quentin Westberg, a starter who has caused problems for Atlanta United in the past, pass over on the right-hand side now to Ronald Hernandez just outside the 18.
Hernandez, the goal scorer, the first goal scorer in that 6-0 win for Atlanta United against Chattanooga in the Open Cup last season. But you're right, you talk about goalkeeper depth. To bring in that wealth of experience behind Brad Guzan, already an established keeper in the world of football, sounds like that was a priority for Atlanta United in the offseason. And you look at a Sebastian Guerra, who is on the bench, the 22-year-old Colombian that's played with the Atlanta Twos, that has had caps with the Colombian U-20 national team. Clement Diop, the former New England Revolution goalkeeper.
Yeah, CF Montreal, and once again, another keeper who gave Atlanta United fits at times at Stade Saputo a couple of seasons ago. So it seems like all of these goalkeepers that had the games of their lives against Atlanta United, Garth Lagerwey and the front office and Carlos Bocanegra were like, tell you what, we're going to sign him.
If you can't beat him, make him join you. Is that how that works?
There you go.
52nd minute at Finley Stadium. Hernandez, the 25-year-old, 13 appearances for the Atlanta United first team in 2022, coming up from the Twos. Ball on his right foot. Lobs down the line.
Good control there by Luke Brennan.
The 17-year-old in a race to the goal line, squares it across. And it's a left-footed finish that saved the shot from Tyler Young, saved by Burke on the first real threat of the second half.
And that's what you're looking for from Atlanta United. We mentioned Luke Brennan, all of the minutes he played last year for Atlanta United 2. And when we talk about Atlanta United 2 players playing today, Noah Cobb, Aiden McFadden, who got first team minutes, Alan Carlton, Firmino, Brennan, Mejia, Sabatu, all of these young players, under 20, under 18, were playing against adults, and I mean that, late 20s, early 30s, so going up against players who are 10, 12 years older than they are, not something foreign to them, not intimidated by that kind of an activity, and you're seeing right here with Luke Brennan with that first rush here in the 51st minute, creating a second corner now, sent away by Chattanooga, and they're going to come here in transition. Can Atlanta United get back? And you see all of those young sets of legs do exactly that, headed off nicely there with that attack, and that's the experience of Ronald Hernandez.
Hernandez, the Venezuelan, backs it up to Kofi Tuamasi. Tuamasi, another guy to watch, but one of the more experienced guys you'll see in the second half for Atlanta at 26 years
old. Yeah, Tuamasi will be spending time right now. He's signed by Atlanta United too, so right now it's looking like MLS Next Pro for him, too much on that pass as they were looking for David Mejia on the left-hand side. But Tuamasi has a history as a defensive midfielder from time in Romania and Germany. So once again, getting to know you, how does Kofi Tuamasi, with the first elements of practice and being now here in game state in front of Quentin Westberg with Ronald Hernandez to his right, Noah Cobb to his left, how does Tuamasi as a right center back integrate? How does he feel? How does he get adjusted to what's going on right now in this first action? Noah Cobb, 24, we'll get into the discussion there when these players touch the ball for Atlanta United and for CFC. We got trialists to talk about for CFC as well, but there's a lot of detail that we can get into here in the following 45 minutes or so about the action that you're seeing in front of you.
This is Taylor Krull for Chattanooga. It's about creating depth for Rod Underwood. That's the goal this afternoon for Chattanooga FC, as Leonard Acosta, who has experience in NISA, flubs it out for an Atlanta throw-in. Former Chicago House defender Acosta, a 20-year-old from Chicago, wearing number 13 and applying the pressure here as it's back to Tumasi. And that's good work by Atlanta to climb out of that Chattanooga pressure.
Confident work from Westberg, using his feet, finding the open space, and starting a break the other way. And this is something else to watch for Atlanta United if you're a fan of the five stripes here today. Working their way forward, how many passes does it take to build out of the back, to get into the attacking half, work their way forward? Something else to watch, yes, it is this group that is out here for the second 45, but as they're all learning from Gonzalo Pineda, how long does it take, how many passes does it take, how do you continue to work your way as we're watching from left to right here is part of the things that are important for the philosophy of Atlanta United.
Chattanooga trying to chop the threat away. They'll try and carry it out of the back here and have the help of a free kick. Here in the 56th minute.
Question from our friends at the Scarves and Spikes podcast. Thanks for the compliment, by the way. I wanted to know how the atmosphere was. It sounds loud over the air. On the Atlanta side, great to see Machope Chole have a good start. Aruju needs the confidence. I would agree with both of those assessments, SSP. I would definitely agree with that, where it was good to see Machope Chole with that confidence and be that, he can be trouble for defenses because he is such an atypically built winger. And like I said, I mean that with his lankiness, it's legs and speed, and you're seeing it. He is a bit of a unicorn, Machope Chole. And seeing him healthy, A, out here integrating, B, and C, having these confident moments like we saw when he was working his way on the left-hand side, creating opportunities for Atlanta United. You love to see that. Once again, we mentioned the confidence of having Luis Aruju out there. And Gonzalo Pineda sitting there saying, okay, you're going to take the penalty. I thought that was a big moment, too. Ronald Hernandez down the right-hand side trying to keep it in, and it's going to stick with Atlanta United with a throw halfway through the 57th minute.
Yeah, two goals for Aruju in the first half in this 3-3 game. Also two goals for Chattanooga forward Marcus Nagelstad, the NISA Golden Boot winner in 2022, finds himself on the bench in this second half at Reindeer Hot Dog, which I love, on Twitter. Asks us, Chattanooga has so many trialists. They're 3 weeks premature with their prep, yet they've pressed this Atlanta team really well at times, looking dangerous on the counter, and especially from the wide areas. And Nagelstad showing he's that apex predator up top. If you're Rod Underwood, I don't think you could be more pleased with what you saw from the first team in the first half, as it's a left-side threat from Chattanooga that's just shielded away by Krull and will be chased out for a Chattanooga throw-in. Marcus Nagelstad, the 31-year-old, looking to have a repeat of that 20-goal performance that he put on in NISA during Chattanooga's second-place finish last season, their best finish since joining the league a few years ago. No doubt that in year two of the Rod Underwood era, the goal is to win that first pro trophy for Chattanooga FC in NISA. And Marcus Nagelstad going to be a huge part of that. But I do think the way Chattanooga pressed in that first half has to be a very pleasant surprise to every Chattahooligan in this building.
No doubt about it. You know, you're going to focus on you. That's what Rod Underwood has said this entire time. We're going to focus on us. We're not really looking at, you know, game tape to get prepared. We're going to try to work on ourselves. And you saw that in the first 45 minutes as Leonard Acosta is there to defend Ronald Hernandez to keep Atlanta United to a throw just inside their own, just inside halfway. Continues to plot its way down this near side into Alan Carlton from Hernandez. He finds Noah Cobb. But you focus on you. That's the whole thing that we heard from Rod Underwood this week, and that's what they're absolutely going to do. Shot from 30 deflected.
And it's Firmino battling in the box, wanting a whistle, doesn't get it. And Hernandez will lob far side. Header is there. Follow-up shot deflected out. And it's an Atlanta corner kick.
Off of Andreas Jackson, who touched it last and was there. Now let's see how this lines up on the corner. Initially, the first two corners that were taken over on the far right-hand side by Luke Brennan.
Very active first 15 minutes in the second half by Brennan, the 17-year-old.
Low-line drives. Let's see what happens here.
Chattanooga will clear the danger. Brennan, 28 games for the Twos in 2022. I know you saw a lot of him on the ball now.
Absolutely.
Offside flag up. I believe that's the first one of the game.
Yeah, it is.
Which is unusual in the 60th minute, but Luke Brennan hard to miss with the big flowing hair. But when you talk about the moxie of a 17-year-old kid playing, like you said, with grown adults that often, 28 games last year, the youngest goal scorer for the Twos last season, got that U.S. Men's National Team U19 call-up.
Yep.
I mean, you talk about a guy that can change the tone of a game when he comes in.
And played a lot on the left-hand side for Jack Collison and Atlanta United, too, last year, and became more and more comfortable with the reps that he was getting for the Twos here, as you see Leonard Acosta working it centrally for Chattanooga FC, keeping possession now is Nick Burns. But when you see a Luke Brennan not afraid to go in and mix it up with 25, 26, 28, 32-year-olds and do his thing and a foul's called.
That's Krim down for Chattanooga, going to get right back up for the CFC free kick.
And you mentioned what it's like to see just the comfort level, the confidence level of someone like a Luke Brennan continue to grow. We've seen it with a lot of the guys that are Andy United here in the second 45 minutes. Alan Carlton, 41 in Reds, another example. Last season, Alan Carlton, 5'8", 125 pounds.
Younger brother of Andrew Carlton.
Yep, Andrew Carlton, who is in USL Championship currently, if memory serves. I want to say he's with Vegas. I think he's a new signing for Las Vegas Lights this year. But confident, not afraid to mix it up, not afraid to challenge those that were older of him. And you're seeing just the confidence level of a lot of the young talent for Atlanta United. There for the Twos now here on display in the second 45. David Mejia is another example of that. It's going to be the same sentence said over and over.
Right.
Another example of youth and confidence. Another example of youth and confidence. And you're seeing a lot of that applied to who we're seeing here dressed in red here in the second 45.
This afternoon's match presented by First Bank. If you're just joining us on 11 Sports, Lucas Panzeca, John Nelson with you. If you have a question, whether it's about a Chattanooga trialist, an Atlanta United Academy member, and that's a nice move by Hernandez to still get the service off. Brennan with the control, top of the box, didn't have the angle, and it's dropped off. Atlanta going to have to reset here with Firmino. Broken up by CFC, but the pressure stays on Hernandez. The right foot, service curled across the way, and it's going to drift all the way to the far touchline where Chattanooga will have a throw-in.
Was looking for Daniel Sabatu there in as your center forward there for Atlanta United, too. And Daniel Sabatu, once again, another one of the young players for Atlanta United, has come through the academy. Injuries held him back last season for Atlanta United, too. But Sabatu gives you a different element. He gives you that physical presence there in the middle of the attack on the front line for Atlanta United, and did so for the Twos. It'll be interesting once again to see as Sabatu continues to grow into his body how the challenge is going to be there.
It's a good lifted ball for Tyler Young, just a little bit too much on it. It's cleaned up by Burke.
And so you once again you see how the integration is with all of this young talent that is here for Gonzalo Pineda and for Atlanta United. And the future is bright for a lot of these players. This is an opportunity today to show Coach Pineda how they're continuing to grow. And if you were to ask Gonzalo Pineda about players that he really is looking at, the youth players, he's mentioned a Johnny Fortune who is not playing today. He's mentioned Noah Cobb who is, I mean, he was getting quality minutes in USL Championship at the age of 15.
Right.
And not backing down from anyone. Noah Cobb was getting minutes against professional athletes in USL Championship before he could drive. And that's what you're getting here with Atlanta United and all of their young talent, whether it's Cobb or Carlton or Brennan or Mejia or Sabatu, all of these names, this next wave of talent coming through for Atlanta United on display, getting key minutes, 45 minutes against the Nisa side. I think it's another stage and another step in the confidence and the growth that we're seeing here with Atlanta United. Noah Cobb now with the ball centrally at the back for Atlanta United. Question from Edwin Pintor. EP's watching live from Statesboro. Thank you for the compliment, sir. Three questions. Is Pineda the coach with the most pressure to start the season? I don't think so. I think that it might be somebody like a Greg Vanney in Los Angeles with the Galaxy. And considering that Greg Vanney is the temporary sporting director with LAG, I think that that's one. I think that Nick Cushing in NYC, with all the turnover that you're seeing there, with a lot of players out, a lot of talented players out, Nino Sagafi letting that go. I think that Nick Cushing is going to have an eye on him. Fair catch called for by Jonathan Birkengrab.
The football references are strong today.
Hey, that's what we're here for. I mean, hey, it is the home of SoCon football and Tennessee Chattanooga.
The Chattanooga Mocs play on this field.
And longtime home of the Division I AA. I just dated myself with that reference, championship. See, I can't call it FCS. I've got to call it I AA.
I was here just a couple of months ago doing Tennessee State Championship football here at Finley Stadium, a multi-purpose venue in Chattanooga, Tennessee, but only one purpose for it today, and that is for Gonzalo Pineda and Rod Underwood to figure out just what they have heading into 2023. I certainly agree with you on Vanney. It doubles down when you have that added role, especially in a town like Los Angeles.
Pete, you got to keep up with the Joneses over at now BMO Stadium, and it's no longer the bank.
Without a doubt. LAFC and what they did this past season and just the nature of the expectations of LA Galaxy, that's one to watch in 2023.
Question two from EP. Where is Taylor Gray for CFC?
Gray on the team sheet today. Certainly a fan favorite for this team, as this is backed up for Nick Burns. Tried to square up a left-footed piece of service that gets deflected, and now back with Leonard Acosta. So Taylor Gray initially thought he was going to play today. We have not seen him. No word on what the cause of that might be, but I do expect Taylor Gray to be a big part of what Chattanooga does in 2023. 8 goals, 2 assists, just a fan favorite. Played every match of the 2022 season, finished second on the team in scoring, was named to the NISA Best 11 first team. So no Taylor Gray today, but of course Chattanooga's preseason will continue on as a free kick is called in favor of CFC. And in fact, Chattanooga will be back here February 18th, opponent to be announced in a closed off match, but March 4th, One Knoxville SC, Battle of Tennessee professional squads, will happen right here at Finley Stadium. The boys in blue taking on One Knox. And don't forget, 2023 CFC annual passes and flex passes now available for all men's and women's matches, as that free kick service a little bit short does still end up at the feet of Fabian Rodriguez, the younger brother of Damian Rodriguez, who you saw with the first half assist. But here's Atlanta.
Sabatu tracking it down on the right.
Daniel Sabatu.
Swept in the air, and it was there. It was there again for Tyler Young.
No goals in this second half. There were plenty of them in the first. If you're a Chattanooga fan, consider the club pass if you're going to find yourself here at Finley Stadium looking to support men's and women's matches in 2023.
And then question number three from Edwin Pintor in the borough. Is USL 1 champion Taylor Kroll on trial with Chattanooga? 17 should be out there here in the second half, I believe.
Taylor Kroll is out there, a center back that they're really taking a good look at, Rod Underwood. I think the back line, a big focal point as far as how the trialists can impact things. In the first half, you saw Jungwoo So play the entire first 45, taking a strong look at him, can play left back, right back, also move up and play as the six. But one guy to look at, if you're a Chattanooga FC fan that is on this field, that they're taking a strong look at the center back position, number 24, Abdul Koistra. Or I'm sorry, at the left back position, I misspoke. A guy that came in with the open tryout, a left-footed left back, which can be hard to come by, has experience with Philadelphia Lone Star, with the Dayton Dutch Lions, former Wisconsin Badger that transferred to Northern Kentucky, but now playing a little bit in front of that back line, wearing the number 24, just making himself available there, shoulder to shoulder currently with number 61 Sabatu of Atlanta United, has a strong chance to make an impact for CFC in 2023. So defensively, although Rod Underwood looking at all areas when it comes to depth, I think defensively there are really some guys to key in on today as far as the trialists go in this 3-3 matchup in the 70th minute. Completely new 11s on both sides. Really getting a feel for this match as Quinton Westberg in goal for Atlanta United.
Firmino now. Give to Alan Carlton. Carlton was looking for either Hernandez or Luke Brennan down the central channel. Tomasi there for Atlanta United. Firmino trying to get it away from Abdul Koistra. And looks like you're going to get a foul called on Joseph Boone as both he and Alan Carlton were going for possession. Atlanta United working down the left-hand side. David Mejia looking for Sabatu just outside the six. Another go-round for Atlanta United here. Alan Carlton, through ball, finds Brennan. Luke Brennan cuts it back to his left, leaves it, shot right on, third chance for Tyler Young. And Jonathan Burke was there for CFC.
So Young, the former Big South Offensive Player of the Year during his time at Campbell University in North Carolina, second round draft pick in 2022. What kind of impact do you think a guy like Tyler Young could have for the Atlanta Tubes?
You're looking at an attacking midfielder, two-time Big South Offensive Player of the Year. And we've seen so far three chances here in 25 minutes where Tyler Young was either on the back post, working his way down the middle. The chances were there. You see the speed, looking for those gaps, looking for those opportunities. And so I think Tyler Young will be definitely someone to keep an eye on as we go through here in training camp. Knights Hussein Nisa on the Twitters. Any chance a player like Damian Rodriguez gets a look from Atlanta? He left three of three defenders in the dust in the first half. You're always looking. That's the best way that I can phrase it. You're always looking, whether it's internally, you're looking at what you're trying to develop and what you're trying to build, but also there are folks that will stand out on tape. And I think that anyone who is watching this match today, regardless of if they are tied to the 17s or whether they're tied to CFC, anyone watching this match today, you can't escape tape now because how easy it is to watch games these days. It's not like in the old days where it's like, okay, you're trying to find something on satellite. It's like, is my satellite working? Tape is easy to find. Matches are easy to find. You can watch them anywhere these days. Damian Rodriguez is not a secret. I think that's safe to say.
Well, some guys just stick out, right? And Rodriguez has stuck out to Chattanooga coaches, evaluators, and fans for the last couple of years now, only as a 20-year-old, and look, familiar to the Atlanta area, a Dalton High School state
champion.
Just
a half hour south of here.
Right.
Catamount soccer, solid.
Two-time state champion for Dalton. And Rod Underwood, head coach at Chattanooga FC, was very meticulous about how he wanted to bring Damian Rodriguez along last season. Wanted to do it slowly. Wanted to put him in advantageous situations rather than just throwing him into the fire. But coming into 2023, I think Chattanooga fans are going to see a lot more of Damian Rodriguez down that right flank. And, you know, you said it, Knights Hussein Nisa on Twitter, that sequence near the end of the first half through three Atlanta defenders, squaring up McGrath for that third goal that equalized things 3-3. And that's where we were at halftime. That's where we are now in the 74th minute. Damian Rodriguez has that ability that, with the snap of a finger, can create a spark at any moment. The 5-5 winger, I think, is going to be much more influential for Chattanooga FC because this coaching staff feels he's just a lot better prepared to have that type of role versus what he was in 2022. Not to say he wasn't ready for it in 2022, but this staff understood the potential that they have in Damian Rodriguez. They wanted to be very intentional about how they brought him along. And with that said, the same goes for his younger brother, Fabian, who is on the field at the moment. Fabian Rodriguez, same story. Dalton High School out of Georgia, wearing number 21, a winger, product of the North Georgia Soccer Academy. Saw some time last year against Metro Louisville and Charlotte FC, MLS Next Pro. So the Fabian, or the Rodriguez brothers, a great example of what Chattanooga are trying to do with their young players. And if you're an Atlanta fan, why not keep an eye on those guys?
Well, and remember, as you've been mentioning the schedule for Chattanooga FC, there were some other towns that were mentioned in there that are a part of the Southeast footprint. Nashville, Knoxville,
Memphis.
Memphis, it's a part of the discussion. Like I said, tape does not escape.
Right.
And so this game will get out, and folks will sit there, and they will look at players for Chattanooga FC, and they will see what they're looking for. And so trust me, you will have folks with the magnifying glass staring at matches like this, seeing talent that fits what folks are looking for, as we see Noah Cobb defending there for a deep throw for Chattanooga FC. And don't be surprised as things continue to grow and develop with the Rodriguez brothers, specifically, since that's what we're talking about. Players like that will get noticed. The young players for Atlanta United will get noticed. Whether it's, you know, Noah Cobb, who has been getting minutes, Luke Brennan's been getting national minutes, national attention. There are young players for Atlanta United. There are players for CFC that are going to get looked at in one manner, way, shape, or form. So no worry about anyone not getting looked at for a double negative. And my mother, I'm sure, who's the English major, just heard that, and she was cringing as she was listening to what I was saying. But no, tape does not lie, and tape will get out.
Koistra down for Chattanooga. A quick message from Nima Sagafi, our referee this afternoon.
And I think that's what they are. I think that they are just messages today. Nima Sagafi making sure that the match is understood for what it is. Looking for Luke Brennan over the top.
That's thumped clear.
Jonathan Burke had to get there in a hurry. That speed of Luke Brennan on display for Atlanta United. Ronald Hernandez back to Tumasi. Line to Noah Cobb is cut off, so he'll go back to Quentin Westberg.
Now this, it's a big day for Rod Underwood, Chattanooga FC head coach, a guy who was born and raised in the Atlanta area.
Yep.
As Atlanta United will try to spark something here.
Mejia.
Oh, the left-footed try just curls wide. But Rod Underwood, as Chattanooga sets up a goal kick, born and raised in the Atlanta area, he remembers the Atlanta Chiefs. Mm-hmm. He remembers the Silverbacks. He saw indoor soccer come and go. And even he told us this week, I never imagined that it could possibly look like what it does today. And you look around at Finley Stadium, 6,000 people on hand, Chattahooligans on one side, the 17s on another. And you've got this sort of, not really a hidden gem, but a gem of Southern soccer culture right in front of you in scenic city. And for Rod Underwood to be on the touchline for a game like that, coaching against what is now his hometown team, it's got to be a special moment for the former Stumptown coach that now heads into his second season in charge of CFC.
And for Atlanta United, from their perspective, they've made a point from the beginning to try to reach out in the Southeast and understand that the sport is growing the way that it is. Coming here to Chattanooga to play CFC, you know, a handful of years ago, to be that first soccer game for Atlanta United. Working your way in and around the Southeast, being that grande at the same time, and being that global presence, whether it's with transactions or presence and where you're going to have training camps and such. Atlanta United understands about being a good steward just as well. Nice ball. Brennan tracks it down. Step overs on the right-hand side just outside the 18. Looking for Hernandez. Hernandez gains possession. after bumping Leonard Acosta off the ball. Doesn't quite get enough on
offside
to
flag.
Keep it in. The offside flag is up anyway, so it's going to be a goal kick for it's going to be a kick for Jonathan Burke here with 12 minutes plus remaining. But you have Atlanta United understands the value of being that steward in the Southeast.
How about that? We have a booking. Ronald Hernandez with a stern talking to from Sagafi. And how about the most experienced player on the field for Atlanta United getting shown the yellow amongst his...
So let's see, 79th minute, yellow card, Ronald Hernandez.
Okay. Amongst his teammate, largely from the twos.
Quentin Westberg might be... I think Quentin Westberg is older than Ronald Hernandez, but yes.
Yes, as is Tomasi, so 26 years
26.
Old.
So of field players, he's right there at the top when it comes to looking at birth certificates.
Right.
Noah Cobb with the speed, and we've seen that a lot, you know, tracking balls down. Aiden McFadden now trying to shield it from CFC to earn a throw for Atlanta United, and he does. But, yeah, we got something we didn't necessarily think we were going to get. We got a card.
Do you think we see any more changes from either side here in these last 10 or so minutes?
I mean, we don't see players warming up on either end line. I think that this is what you're going to be seeing over the next 10 plus minutes.
And when you're trying to evaluate a guy, especially a guy at the age of a 17, 18 year old prospect for the Atlanta Twos, as Nick Firmino spins away and it ends up with Hernandez on the touchline. There's Brennan trying to turn it in the corner, and under pressure it's out for a Chattanooga throw in. I mean, what kind of evaluation can you really grab out of 10 minutes of play in a game like this?
And so you've got one group at 45, second group of 45. Noah Cobb wins the header there. Tomasi launches it forward. David Mejia can't time the hop. Gets to Taylor Krul and back to John Burke. And CFC will try it again here late in the 81st minute. And you understand that, you know, there's some schools of thought where you go 30, then play the middle 30, then play another 30. But the philosophy for Gonzalo Pineda today, 2:45.
Same for Rod Underwood, it would seem, on the left side with Nick Burns. And what a sliding challenge there to create an opportunity by Carlton. And Brennan is off to the races.
Gets it from Sabatu in a hurry. Defense is there by Nick Burns. It'll be a deep throw for Atlanta United. And I don't think we have the mega ball situation here in the final 10 minutes with a tie game. But Ronald Hernandez looking for a partner. Finds it in Sabatu. Hernandez, chip with the left. Headed away. Outside the 18, the speed of Aiden McFadden tracks it down. McFadden with the left, looking, headed out one more time. Alan Carlton now for Atlanta United, keeps possession, looking over both shoulders, trying to find an outlet, and he does. And McFadden on the left. Headed, but not all the way out. Brennan trying to keep possession. Leonard Acosta was there, and it's going to be a late set piece for Atlanta United. And out comes the magic spray, and it looks like it's going to be 18 and a half yards out as Luke Brennan earns a set-piece opportunity for Atlanta United here late in the match.
So a free kick from a dangerous area here in the 83rd minute. And while this game, you could say, has hit a lull with all the new faces, there is still a game on the line, and it's tied up at 3. With 7.5 minutes plus stoppage time left to find a winner. Hernandez trying to do that here.
Nima Sagafi measuring off the 10, gets out the magic spray. Gentlemen, if you would please, behind that line. 5 in the wall for CFC, and it is just outside the 18 for Ronald Hernandez. Let's see what Hernandez has in mind here. No one laying down behind the wall for CFC. Just misses over the bar. Hernandez couldn't get the ball up and have it work its way back down just under the bar. tight quarters for Ronald Hernandez there to try to get goal number four for Atlanta United here with 6.5 plus stoppage time to go.
This is Krim. Those supporter groups urging their teams on in the final 6 minutes plus stoppage time.
He's at Lucas Panzica on Twitter, LucasPanzica. I'm at OSG Nelson. Any other questions you guys have, go ahead and fire them off here in the final 6 minutes. Brennan with possession. Hernandez, outside of the boot, McFadden. Mejia tries to turn in, looking for McFadden too much on it, but Chattanooga FC can't work their way back in transition. Back and forth now, Alan Carlton. Back to Noah Cobb. Center circle, Carlton to Tomasi. Traditionally a central defender at his stops in Europe, working as a right center back today for Atlanta United. Firmino took a peek. Sabatu tried to leave it for him, couldn't regain. Tom Marriott, one of the trialists for CFC, looking to launch it forward. Pass Noah Cobb, chance for CFC, but there's Noah Cobb, and that's what folks have come to expect from Noah Cobb, tracking it down and stopping the opportunity there for CFC, but it's going to be a late corner with 4 minutes to go.
So could be the most concrete opportunity for Chattanooga in this second half. You know, it's funny. Chattanooga certainly will be confident with what they did in the first 45 when it was mostly first team on first team, but really where the quality has shined through for Atlanta United, it's been in the second half with a lot of the twos and the young guys going up against several Chattanooga trialists
who have that experience playing with one another as a unit, going up against trialists who are trying to make an impact. Quentin Westberg can't track it down. It'll be another corner for CFC. But, I mean, if you think about this lineup, Cobb, McFadden, Carlton, Firmino, Brennan, Mejia, Sabatu, all time with the twos last season for Atlanta United. So those relationships that we talk about, they're there.
That chemistry has shown out in this second half with Atlanta controlling the pace, but Chattanooga just trying to establish something in Atlanta's half. The ball over the top will be cut off by Tomasi, and it's an Atlanta throw-in. So you see Aiden McFadden there wearing number 37 for Atlanta United towards the far side of the field in red. I love this journey that McFadden has taken, the 24-year-old from Westchester, Pennsylvania, the 59th overall pick of the 2021 Super Draft out of Notre Dame. I mean, last season, after the preseason in Mexico, which Atlanta will do again in the coming weeks, by the way, assuming he would be with the twos throughout the course of 2022, actually got tickets to the season opener of the 2022 MLS campaign in Atlanta against Sporting Kansas City. Just went to watch the game with some teammates, as McFadden see him on the ball now to watch the 3-1 win against Sporting Kansas City in the stands. Next thing you know, as the ball is channeled down the left side, Atlanta's going to try to square up an opportunity in the middle, and it's at the foot of Hernandez. And he's backed up to the goal line, and it's good defensive pressure by Chattanooga. And next thing you know, Aiden McFadden is called up to the first team in the second MLS fixture of 2022, and he makes his debut in Colorado.
Yeah, he does.
Just a few days later. But ended up playing a good bit for Atlanta United in 2022.
Yeah, 11 matches, 8 starts, and once again it was out of necessity because of all of the injuries that we were talking about in the first 45. You had 20 injuries, 17 players, and here comes CFC in transition in the 89th.
Shin guard left in the dust by Tom Marriott. And Joseph Boone is thumped away. There's Cobb again, forcing the corner kick. Feels like he is everywhere along this Atlanta back line.
Vision and presence have always been there for Noah Cobb. These opportunities that have been there for CFC here in the last, say, 10 to 12 minutes, Noah Cobb has quashed them each and every time. The calming force there at the back here in the second 45 for Atlanta United.
But we will see some changes for Chattanooga as Kostiatin Domorodsky, formerly of Duluth FC, Duluth, I should say, enters the game, as will Caleb Tammy and Noah Sikoria. Fabian Rodriguez, Taylor Krull, Joseph Boone to the bench for Chattanooga. Rod Underwood looking for a winner in the 90th minute.
No doubt. Domorodsky, a Christian Brothers product, if I remember correctly.
That's right, out of Memphis, Tennessee.
Five goals for Duluth FC in the NPSL season last year. Tomasi there, and he will clear it for Atlanta United. Another chance for a throw for CFC. But Rod Underwood, Duluth FC finished second in their conference last year in the NPSL Midwest. So having Kostya Domorodsky, more offensive firepower late. Domorodsky, another one of those trialists. Caleb Tammy, I think, is also a Christian Brothers product, if memory serves.
That's right. So we've hit 90.
And the magic number is 1.
So will we have a winner in this second half? This is Hugo Martinez out for an Atlanta throw at midfield. And you can see the urgency picking up here in the final 60 seconds. Ronald Hernandez. Brennan. You feel I can create a chance at any moment in the final third, but
too much from Carlton there. Noah Cobb having to sprint to track it down.
Atlanta running out of time. Chance raining down from both supporter groups. What an afternoon of the beautiful game it has been in the scenic city.
Good look from Westberg to McFadden. McFadden and Mejia on the left-hand side.
Oh, it's punched away, and one more opportunity. Oh. Open net. John Burke may have just solidified what for Chattanooga FC will be a monumental result, preseason or not.
You got to keep an eye on Luke Brennan, who collided with John Burke there in the end. Physio's out for Atlanta United. Obviously, we'll keep an eye on that as we go forward, but final whistle from Nima Sagafi, 90 minutes down, 6 goals on the board, 3 each side.
And your final score from Finley Stadium, Atlanta United 3, Chattanooga FC 3. All 6 goals coming in the first 45, plenty of new faces in the second half. And when it's all said and done, we are level after the first preseason match of 2023. Atlanta United will look ahead to a trip to Mexico. They'll be at Atlante FC February 4th, followed by a trip to Cruz Azul, and then they'll head home to host Toluca FC. The MLS opener coming February 25th against San Jose. Meanwhile, Chattanooga will head to Memphis for a closed-off match February 11th against 901. They will be back here next time Chattanooga fans will see this team in Finley Stadium. March 4th, a friendly against One Knoxville Soccer Club. This afternoon, 2 teams on different levels of the American soccer pyramid. For Chattanooga, John, it's about the big picture, about finding depth pieces, and they're not hanging back. They're not going to sit back and counter because that's just not what they want to do. Zan keeps it in. Could be an opportunity for CFC, and it's a one-touch finish. Slotted into the right corner. And we're level in Scenic City.
Final whistle from Nima Sagafi, 90 minutes down. 6 goals on the board, 3 each side.